Okay, we're back, and this time we're going to play the Southern Pinscher campaign. We just played the Northern Pinscher campaign to Modlin. Now we're going to play the Southern Pinscher campaign, and of course, both are attempting to get to Varsa. So we fought through the Modlin Fortress. Now let's see, with direct engagements, join the Southern Pinscher. We shall go to Varsa. All right, our redeployment to southern Poland is complete, and 14th Army already has a directive for us to pursue. The other day, another order for us to rush to combat. A, thankfully for us, this mission should be pretty straightforward. Primary objective, capture all victory hexes all the way to Lvov. Okay. The general advance across Poland has pressed our enemy hard, but we have to keep up the momentum to prevent them from reorganizing. Crossing the San River here should allow us to keep the pressure on. Just be sure to watch out for limited Polish counterattacks to our advance. Some of our Slovakian allies have reported major Polish transport movement in this region. I suggest we simply engage any transports we come across. We can figure out what is going on after we disable them. Thank you, Simon. To victory for okay, so it looks like, yeah, we got a Polish train. So the objective is to cut off this retreat going on from Rzeszów, get across the river, take Lubica, Zao, and then head to Lwów. So not super complicated. It appears we only have one airfield, so we're going to have some limited aircraft deployment. Fighters, Stuka, maybe a 110 C or D, a couple of strategic bombers, and that's going to be it. All right, we'll be back to set the order of battle. Okay, we're back, and we have received a new hero. Diedrich Bergman is a hero. Prudent. Gets defense bonus for each point of lost strength, so he gets stronger the weaker he is. Okay, interesting. don't know who I will assign that to, but I got a message here from high command. Interesting report just came in, my general. Apparently, our salvage and repair crews have come across the wrecks of Polish armored trains. Everybody over on Telegram is apparently posting. Polish armored trains, so many in fact that we've taken it upon themselves to cobble together a fully armed and functional Panzerzug for their own units. This is a train again. I must say this is certainly unexpected. I think we'll have to make some kind of arrangements to reward their initiative. Just remember that whenever you deploy this particular unit to the field, it is restricted moving to rail on railroad lines only. I got my armored train destroyed. Previous battle, and I'm gonna try to do the same. I think they're useless, so they give them to me, but I think they're useless. All right, so looks like we have very dense terrain, very dense forest through here. There's only a really limited transformation. We're gonna have to get some mobile units through here to cut off whatever this retreat thing is going on from Rzeszów and get my heavier stuff across the river. So I'm gonna need a bridger unit, it looks like. All right, first things first, going to restore everything to full strength, reinforce all my units before this battle. I still have the Char B1 in this scenario. That'll probably be deployed, and I'm going to put everything into reserve to start with. And let's get my aircraft set up first. I have no paratroopers allowed, so I'm going to get my two best VF-109s. I'm gonna get actually we have 109E, and I don't think I can upgrade yet. There's no other aircraft, so I'm going to deploy him because he's got less experience, and deploy this one because he's got more experience. So keep trying to grow them. I'm gonna need a Stuka, put him here. Gonna need my best strategic bombers. Nope, no new models of those. So I'm going to put them here in the formation. A couple of JU-88s for the heavy bombing. And then I am going to also put in a BF-110. I got three of those. I'm going to put one of them there. And I'm also going to get my Storch to scout. And that's going to be my Air Force, I think, for this particular battle. All right. Now, in terms of ground units, can I upgrade my scout cars? Ooh, yes, I can. I can upgrade this one to a Samchod Pazerzi Wars versus. Okay, I'm gonna put him out. Right here, so he can scout ahead. I'm gonna put him by Char B1. Tank is gonna be there. My best troopin' are going to be my grenadiers. Are gonna be there. Brucken Pioneer, I'm going to need a bridger to get across, at least one. My Azul Infantry are going to be part of this group, as are my Pioneers. So I've got one of each type of unit. An artillery piece in, my heavy artillery. I'm going to go with Wehrmacht infantry. It's my best tank unit. This guy right here has a medal. What does he have? He's a survivor. My best tank unit is this Panzer 38T, and I don't think I can improve him on that. I don't think there's any. Yeah, there's no. Overstrength him to 12. Best Scharfschütze unit. I'm gonna put him here. And then the rest have to be tanks. Panzer 2. And another. And a 37mm anti-tank gun. Pussy gun, though, it is. Alright, I think that will do it for my initial force as we get started. So, I don't know, that's very limited. I don't know if I'm going to be able to carry this out. Sturmpanzer into the action. A second Scharfschütze. Command tank. One of these Panzer 1s is going to become a second command tank for a second Panzer 1. I'm going to get back to full strength. I'll put this Panzer 1 out there. I think we are good and ready to go. Let's see what happens. Did I sign my new... Looks like we're ready. Yeah, some of my units have not been given full replacements. Yep. That's this Char 1B. Oh, they have an armored train too. Ooh, good for them. Let's get this armored train selected. Hit anything? Car. Oh, the Panzer II. Okay. Hit that with my artillery. I'm going to take it out with my Panzer II. Overrun. Better yet. Alright, what am I going to do with my overrun? I'm going to Stuka this tank, this TKS. And two. Finish him. Can. Get my bridger moved up there. Now I need to take out these Polish infantry outside this village. Because what I do that is to Sturmpanzer them. March my Scharfschützen, yes. I can. Oh, no. There was an anti-tank gun in the way that was invisible for some reason. I have to take him out first. And then march these infantry down. What I'm trying to do is break through this so I can get to whatever is going on down here. Alright, also we have one aircraft in the air. Let's get him taken care of. Annoying Polish Air Force. Will that improve our chances any? Probably not. But it's a losing fight for us, but we're still going to engage in it. And then use our Panzer 1A to knock them out. Okay, so we've made good progress down that way. Now, our 37mm anti-tank gun. We're going to use that against the armored train. We're going to use our heavy artillery on the Starwing. Get nowhere with the armored train. Okay. BF-110C. I have one of those. I hit the armored car. And move my Sharpie 1. My heavy French tank. Okay, I'm going to move my armored car, my captured Polish armored car, to attack these bridgers. Panzer 38T. I'm going to move him this way. Get my command tank. Two strategic bombers. Two holes right here. Can I finish off that armored car? Yeah, I can finish it off. Finished off. first march, my eyes with infantry up here to try to close the road across the San River. My other infantry forward. Forward, and then lastly, I'm going to scout with my storch down across. Oh, there's a whole bunch of forces down there. I'm going to have to take on. Wow. First thing is going to have to get down here to cut this rail line, which is going to be, again, really difficult through all this heavy terrain. Be forced. Two tank units, two light tanks. I'm gonna have to pull my Panzer 35T out of reserve. Where's my 35? Get him down into that fight too. A little more armor. There's no airfields to capture. Lubixau. I don't think that train's going anywhere, though, so we're going to finish that train off. Hard to do without an 88. All I've got is the pussy little 37mm. Do I have any aircraft? Look at this guy. I'll bring him. Guys have seen some battle, but they should have kind of a worn look. Okay, that's it. That's turn one for me. Now it's the Poles' turn. Let's see what they do. I gotta fly some planes up. To attack my bombers, as I suspected, and my artillery. Move some troops. Yeah, they're in full retreat, trying to get back across the river. Oh, I see they're going to send some supply trucks up. Okay. Am I any aircraft going here? Make eliminating this fighter. Okay, my train versus their train. Ooh, did it with my pussy little 37mm. Use my armored car to attack those bridgers. Get down here. I got a chance to get my Charvy 1 across the river and attack that any aircraft emplacement. That will really help me. But the risk of counterattack is very heavy. I can get my Azules across. Get a force across the river there. Use my Scharfschützen. Stuka. This armored car. Zero wipe. Jet tank. Okay. If I leave them there just in a truck, they're going to be very exposed. Okay. What do I have left in terms of bombers? I've got a heavy strategic bomber. It's very important to take out the units. The anti-aircraft units are important. I'm going to reinforce that. They're important to take out because they cause a lot of trouble. Panzer 35 is going to come down through these woods and hit this cargo ship. Panzer 2 is going to hit the cargo truck and destroy him and move on and hit this other cargo truck. Okay, another Panzer. Ooh, I've almost got them cut off. Use my Sturm Panzer. Alright, I'm close to the railroad tracks. It's going to be tough for them to advance out of here. They're trying to get their cargo and their military troops across the river. That's it. That's all I have. Okay. Let's see what the Poles do. I'm gonna come back and attack my other bomber. Attack my Stuka. Shell my Bridger unit. Attack my anti-tank gun. One of my favorite things to do. Cargo trucks across. Okay, number one thing is how do I deal with this infantry right here? Start by using artillery on them. Okay, second artillery piece. Again. Now what I'm going to do is hit him with this 37mm anti-tank gun. And I'm going to switch places, which you can do. Hold down the shift key, press, what you got one unit selected, select the other unit. They move, and now my Scharfschützen goes after. armored train forward to attack them. Got to avoid getting too involved in... Damn, I was almost able to knock this artillery out, but they were able to reinforce it. Azules forward to destroy that infantry. My pioneers forward to get rid of this. Armored car down to cut off the retreat. Alright, my BF-110 ought to be able to finish these guys off. Oh, come on, really? Yeah, what do I do with my heavy strategic bombers? Well, one guy I'm going to go after is this set right here. Swamp. M. My Stuka, what could I Stuka? I could Stuka this tank. It's always a good idea. So my Stuka's against the tanks. Panzer 35T, the less powerful between the 35 and the 38. That heavy counterweight on the torch to keep this all. Alright, I have possession of a new base. I can bring some more aircraft out of mothballs. I can bring my other BF-109, a couple more of my 110 Cs, which have been relatively useless in this campaign so far. And strategic bomber. Okay, now what do I do? I think I try to eliminate these trains and take this supply X. That was very ineffective. I'm going to use my cavalry there. Sturmpanzer. Just keep attacking those trains. Okay. I've got Rezao's supply hex almost surrounded. Yes, these retreating Polish cowards will live to fight another day, but not too much longer. Eight against that infantry, drive them back. Okay, end of turn. Attack my bombers as always. Bring some infantry forward, try to retake the airfield. Love all their invisible infantry, they pull out of nowhere. Alright, we're about to cut off tram line here. Car. Boy, they threw everything in my command tank. Okay, gonna bomb. Three. Tank. Gonna move 37 millimeter up. tank up to almost completely destroy that. Polish TKS. Artillery there. Move my anti-aircraft there. This artillery base forward. Okay, now what do I do? Well, I can attack those easily vulnerable cargo trains, or I can cut off the retreat. Let you stew. My grenadiers. Those Polish troops. My Azuls are going to lose their vehicle by going into the swamp, but it's worth it to kill the enemy. I'll use my grenadiers and my pioneers to take the road intersections. I'm starting to So I'm going to use my heavy bombers here to weaken these infantry. These are dangerous units. Hold up ganging up, especially since I don't know how many more infantry they've got back there. I could if I decided to scout back there. Which I may do. So the idea here is to weaken the enemy infantry so that they can't counterattack. Like I'm hoping to preserve my 37. Storch out this way? Yeah, storch out. There's only a little light tank there. So that's good. Alright. Before I move the Stuka to the new airbase, I'm going to use it to try to help finish off this TKS tank. 35T. Drive him back out into the open where I hope this wimp ass BF. See, can finish him off. Got him. Alright, got him. Alright, now we move our troops in to get these two Polish trains. Reinforce my Sturmpanzer. I'm going to reinforce this Wehrmacht infantry. And we will then be able to try to cross the river from behind. Okay, so we've got taken control of the supply hex there. BF-109. I can do that, but then I'm going to get hit with counterattacks. There are no aircraft in my range. So let me rebase him to this. Outside Lubakow. I hope that I don't lose that airfield in counterattacks. I got four units that could go after my Panzer 38, theoretically, there. So. Alright, my Azuls are going to be on foot for the rest of the battle because they lost their. Send my Sharby 1 up this way to try to encircle Lubakow from behind and hopefully lure this little FT-17 Polish mini tank into a fight with. Oh, the armored train will help protect the airfields. Okay, that's good. Because I got to get this 37mm anti-tank gun reinforced. I hate to lose that one because it's got some experience now. It's almost got a full star of experience. 671, not bad. Okay, pull the shirt. Bringing some cavalry forward to attack my pioneers. He's gained his star. He's got two stars now. Okay, Polish troops are going to retreat. I'm going to move back and take that airfield. Ooh, I really hit my pioneers. Okay. Move back and take this airfield. Here's my Azul's out here. And my Grenadiers. Take them out. Okay, so now I'm going to switch gears with my Sharpie 1. Go after that tank. Duke of that tank. I don't think he's in range. No, shit. I can rebase my Stuka there. My 35T. I will hit these bridgers with. Sharpie shoots in. Get my regular Wehrmacht infantry. My Panzer 2. Panzer 1. Get this force going across the river. Get the bridger here. This will help them cross. Okay. Alright, I cannot hit that. The idea being to weaken these infantry forces so they don't overwhelm my armored car there, which would be, you know, not so good after all that work. Alright, how else do I want to use my air assets here? First of all, reinforce these guys. My armored train on those infantry, Scharfschütze. Use my Panzer 38T. Move my anti aircraft into position before I do this because I don't want these guys. Okay, so, what do I have? I have a BF-110, which I'm going to use to attack this tank, weaken it. I have another BF-110, which I'm going to use to attack this tank, weaken it. I have a free ground attack. Him to this airbase. I say free because he's positioned over him already. I'm going to reinforce that BF-109. I'm going to use that BF-109 to him. And I got two heavy strategic bombers. So this BF-109 to attack that cargo truck. Use this strategic bomber on these forward infantry troops. Okay, guys, you're getting kind of surrounded. You're getting kind of surrounded here. Rebase my Storch scout plane. Oh, I can move. Oh, I have this strategic bomber. It's going to be closer to that anti-aircraft field. I can use one of these bridges. Scout. Now, I can attack that tank with my Sharpie 1. My Sharpie 1's not below 10 yet, so that's pretty good strength-wise. Alright. Scheist, if this tank decides it's going to not reinforce and take this airfield instead, then I'm going to lose these three planes. I'm not going to lose them, they're going to go back to their old bases. Alright, let's see what the Poles do. They're gonna shell my cavalry. Attack my anti-aircraft gun. Move towards my airfield. Take out a reserve. Go after my sharpshoots. In the end, they took the fucking airfield. God damn it. It's an inconvenience. It's not. Cavalry, Scharfschützen, take out that artillery piece. I'm gonna move my Panzer 2 across the way, finish him off, come back and counterattack. The anti-aircraft gun, and seize that airfield. Okay. BF-110C. Attack this infantry. Attack this tank from behind. Take the airfield and go after that infantry. Kill that infantry. Airfield, reinforce those Azuls, reinforce those Pioneers. Get those Grenadiers in place. Thing now is to surround the enemy. Armored train. I almost fucking used this armored train. Eight. Killed them, overran them. Not gonna hit. This tank. See him? Heavy strategic bombers on Lubakow. Can I move this 30? Yeah, I'm going to move 37 millimeter up. Try to take out this tank. Maybe I can get him to surrender. No, fuck no. Alright, can I move this guy forward? I can, but... instead, I'm going to... this command tank is supposed to be a command tank. He's not supposed to really... what is his armor in any way? Panzer 1 command tank. Looks like he's got a 20mm cannon and a coaxial 50 caliber machine gun. Which would make his statistics... soft attack 8. Yeah, that's a 8, heart attack 5. Compared to a Panzer II. His heart attack is 10. But that looks like the same 20mm gun. I'll have to do some research on the Panzer I command tank. Also, I should make him a different color so everybody knows he's the command. Bloody amoeba. Kind of like that. Maybe we'll go with blood red for now. That allows me to reinforce my sharpshoots, who are the only infantry that I have here. And I'm going to use my artillery to hit them. Okay. Base to there for that BF-109. This BF-110C. Stuka I can't use. I can use my heavy bomber, so. And if I use it on that creature, some super damage, and then my Stuka's gotta stay put. Okay. Alright. Holes are gonna continue. Let's get my regular Wehrmacht infantry. Panzer 2 coming up behind. Sturmpanzer. Cavalry on cavalry violence here. Panzer 2 attack. Panzer 1 to swing around and finish him off. My Scharfschütze. Force march them forward. March my other infantry forward. Cargo truck. Artillery piece forward. Attack with my captured Polish armored car. Okay. march my Azul infantry in. Yes, these guys are super good, and they are as good as dead. Okay, let's talk about rebasing. Let's rebase my Stuka. Let's forward airbase. Let's rebase my other strategic bomber. Let's reinforce this strategic bomber, and let's rebase this BF. These poles are virtually surrounded. They got no hope. Okay, I'm going to use my command tank to take this little Polish village. Meanwhile, I'm going to apply all kinds of pressure to these bridgers. I'm going to strategically bomb them with my DO-217. And down. Bring my pioneers forward. And the aircraft gun to take Lubicau. Lubicau, whatever Lubicau. Advance my train all the way to the intersection. Forward prematurely and get my 35T up there, 38T. Okay, my scout storch. I've got a little bit of force there. BF-110. I'm going to rebase it to this base, so I got a couple more of those. Can he be rebased? Yeah. All my bombers going forward. I'll attack these guys. Okay, now I gotta get my armor out front to deal with these tanks and armored cars. And mop up my infantry to finish up. That JU-88A before I move it into a better position. Is that it? Yep, that's it. New turn. Yeah, see, they're gonna come attack my train. Attack my storch. Fine, I don't really care about that train. In fact, it's such a pain in the ass, I want to get rid of it. Scout car here. My Panzer II forward. Move my Sturm Panzer forward. My JU-8 Heavy 8. Move my other JU-88 to this new air base. Actually, let me check. Can I reinforce that? No, I can't. I was looking to see if I could upgrade, because he's got an experience star he should have at his cut everything down here I think I need. Reinforce my Stuka. Send my vehicle intensity out on harassment attack. This DO-17Z experience. Soften them up. Okay. Instead of focusing on my armored train, they came out and got hit by my 37mm tank. Can't help themselves. Come on, fight. This is good. This is good experience for my unit, so I'm going to reinforce. Attack that. Any aircraft unit. DO-17Z. Let's see, his experience is 576. Let's see what it is after we go through this attack. Forward. I think that's it. I don't think there's any other reserve units back here. Yeah. So now it's just a question of surrounding Lvov. Because again, I want to gain that more experience right now. He's got 778. This guy's got 818. Needs a bit more. What's his experience now? 819. Hard to gain anything. That's okay. As David Childress would say, that's okay. Alright. So he's gonna counterattack me. They're gonna hit my Sharby 1. Guys. All right, where's my other JU-88? Command tank up there to boost counterattack capabilities. Okay. No defenses left. Fools. Attention. General Oberst of the 14th Army sends his thanks for your support of their continued advance through southern Poland. He sends his congratulations on the capture of Lvov, and he's confident that 14th Army will lock down the Polish-Hungarian and Polish-Romanian border in a matter of days before we turn our advance north. However, there's another matter I feel compelled to bring to your attention. Our salvage teams have finished securing the Polish convoys we disabled, and they've found something unexpected. About half the transports were military, the other half were civilian. We've secured the Polish civilians for the moment, but we have to decide what to do with them now. As you know, our orders regarding non-combatants is clear. We're supposed to turn them over to our friends at Operational Group B for identification and processing. We've captured so many civilians that we're going to lose valuable time keeping them secure until the OGE can take custody of them. If I may be so bold, suggested my general, we could accidentally lose track of civilians. The OGE might be displeased, but what can they do to us? Nothing but a worthless complaint. Meanwhile, the time and energy we save can surely be put to better and more interesting use. I await your decision in the next battle. I think it's the same thing we have in the other one. We have to decide what to do with the prisoners. Historically, Lvov, also known as Lwow, would be attacked by German forces, but ultimately occupied by Soviet forces, now approaching from the east. Interesting. Okay, that's it. That is going to be the end of Lvov, the Lvov scenario. I'm going to save it right here. To continue, I think there's two missions in the north and two missions in the south. We've completed the first of each. And now we'll see where that takes us in the next game. Oops. Heinrich. Okay. Thanks for being with me. I'll be back for another edition of My Place Panzer.